Hi guys, this is Manas Vilas and you're watching Making of the Filmmaker ESFF event powered by Dios Film Productions. Emirates Short Film Festival is celebrating its 7th edition this year. Over 100 films right from US, UK, all across Europe, India, Pakistan, Iran, Egypt, Turkey, definitely UAE too. All these films will be showcased right from 13th of December to 15th of December at Vox Cinema Dubai. Grand finale will be on 17th of December, the Friday. Dios Film Production is offering platforms to all the filmmakers to promote their films. Today, in our studio, there's a gentleman who is a self-taught filmmaker. He's grown himself over 10 years. He's one of the top film critics in the region. Yeah, is none other than Faisal Hashmi and his team for the film Anwar. Faisal, welcome to Dios Film Productions today.
Pleasure to be here.
Oh, pleasure is all ours, seriously. Would you mind to introduce a gentleman? In fact, the whole UAE knows about him, but still, I have to make it official, so.
Yeah, so this is Ivor Garcias. He's one of the producers on the short film Amber.
Right.
And I'm Faisal Hashmi, I'm the writer-director of the film Amber.
Right. Straight away coming to the film, Amber. The name sounds totally different. What is it all about?
Sure, so Amber is about a barber who's starting his shop in early in the morning,
mm-hmm.
and he realizes the first customer of the day that he gets is hiding a dark secret.
Right.
And the film really just spirals from that point on. And the reason the film is called Amber is because the barber realizes that the customer may have kidnapped a young girl.
Right.
And the young girl might actually be in the trunk of his car right now. And that's and the film is called Amber because the young girl is named Amber. And the film really is following sort of the dilemma of the character into what is he going to do in this situation? What does a normal barber do in such a high-pressure situation where someone's life is at stake?
Wow. So can I say it's a genre of drama or thriller? Can I say that?
Yes, for sure. I mean, it's definitely a thriller first.
Okay.
You know, I've had this idea for the last 4 or 5 years, and the reason I've been holding off into making it is because I needed the right people, including Ivor, including all the other producers, Kurt, Kane, and all the people who came on the film, is to find the right crew to make it, because it's a very difficult movie to make. It's a movie that has no dialogue.
Right.
So it's all in the visuals of the stakes and how you find out what's happening to
right.
these characters. So it is definitely a thriller that puts the audience in the shoes of this person and be like, what would you do? And there's no easy answers, because it's,
okay.
you know, do you try to play hero? Or do you just let this is not your problem and you just let it go? And I think the movie grasps with that idea of what would you do.
Right. And so you said about characters. So what about the actors? I mean, I'm sure that you waited so long to get the right actors. You know, how you came to that characterization?
Actually, Faisal already had in mind
right.
The characters that he wanted to play for the film, but
mm-hmm.
we had to do a screen test and make sure that they fit the right part. And the interesting part was, we also have a very, very top DOP on this film.
Right.
Elias Strad, who did a brilliant job on this film.
Uh-huh.
The actors had to do a lot of rehearsals before they came on for the film. And the interesting part is that because he said there's no dialogue, it's not very easy to carry on the entire film.
Right.
But these guys were on point and very, very good actors.
Right.
So that's Rick Abbey
yeah.
and Joachim.
Yeah,
Joachim is someone I had met. I had gone to a film screening where I had seen a film that he had done.
Right.
And immediately, this is around 2016. So I went up and told him that I have an idea for a film.
Right.
I don't know when I'm going to make it.
Yeah.
I'll probably need a lot more resources than I have currently, but you're going to play my lead role. So I had him, and every time we used to meet, every couple of years, we should talk about the idea. But I'm glad that since then, till when we ended up shooting in 2019,
right.
we were able to actually make it happen with him. And he was in town, and the schedules worked out. So
right.
I'm very fortunate that him and Rick Abbey, who is a veteran actor here, he's been
Absolutely.
Working for so many years. Before I even started being a filmmaker, I've been seeing.
So no dialogue. You know, the film has no dialogue. How long is this film?
This is almost 10 minutes long, yeah.
10 minutes long,
yeah.
No dialogue, but still a thriller. I'm sure that the music and the photography, cinematography must have played a great, I would say it must have given a lot of efforts, great efforts on this particular team. Would you mind to say, you know, a few words about it?
Yeah, sure. So as Ivor mentioned, Elia Strad was our cinematographer in the film, and Kane Rodriguez was the sound recordist and sound designer on the film. And it was really important because, as he mentioned, when you don't have the crutch of dialogue to work with, you, the other things become much more amplified. You know,
absolutely.
The visuals and the sound are telling the whole story.
How did you manage to not to show the camera? I mean, how do you manage to not to show the reflection, I would say?
Yeah, that was definitely a huge challenge on the day. Was not only with
another one. Apart from these challenges, is there any fun moment or anything which you would like to say that, you know, no, Manas, this particular scene was so difficult, or this particular scene was, I thought it, you interpreted as very difficult, but it was just happened. Any particular moment in, I mean, you both are producers, so
yeah.
Probably you both can talk about.
So one thing that was really exciting for the reason why I wanted to do this movie, but also one of the reasons why I wanted to wait and do it right, was because in the finale of the film, there is a fight scene of sorts, you know, that happens. And I was really, this is the first time I've ever shot a fight scene. So I was really nervous in the beginning, and I did a lot of prep. You know, as he said, we did rehearsals. I watch a lot of movies which have fight scenes just to see sort of how the angles work,
mm-hmm.
because, you know, there's nothing worse than watching a bad fight scene, you know. So if you're doing it, you have to do it right, you have to give it sort of the resources that it requires. So, but on the day when he was shooting it, even though we were sort of fighting against time the whole time, it was really fun. And I think if you watch the movie, that's the thing I'm most proud of, is that the energy, all that build up really comes up to these two characters just sort of going at it. And so I'm really excited that I was able to do that. And that's something I've learned now. So
right.
Hopefully when I do other movies, I can, you know, I have more experience sort of doing more action kind of stuff.
What about the post-production? How long did it take?
So post-production took a couple of months, I would say. I was the editor of the film. So
right.
So far, all the films that I've shot or directed, I've also edited. I prefer doing that for short films. So I have a very specific vision when I'm directing of how I want it to look.
Right.
So it took a couple of months. The action scene took a lot more time to edit. You know, so it was a process of like, okay, the first cut is maybe a little bit longer, then you sort of start paring it down.
Mm-hmm.
Sound took a little bit of time. We had to sort of even do some, dubbing and recordings of some
right.
acts, some sounds to sort of make it work. It was a fun process. And the post, so we had a great composer, Isaac Olsen. He's from Sweden, so he's not even based in Dubai, but he did the score for the film. So figuring out what score is required and how to sort of elevate the tension throughout the film. So it was an experimental process, but overall it was very fruitful because the end result really speaks for itself.
It's really a cosmopolitan film, I would say.
Yeah, for sure. I'm always on the lookout for talent. You know, obviously when they're based here, that's even better. But especially with composers,
right.
You know, Swedish people are amazing. He's a young guy, but he's scored my last film as well, Wicked.
Mm-hmm.
So I just went up to him, and he exactly knew the kind of tone that's needed for this kind of scene. And he knew that because there is no dialogue, the music plays now even a bigger important part.
Yeah.
Right. Two things I want to mention is one of the memorable things for me
mm-hmm.
for this film is there was this very important scene that we had to rent a studio. And we had to shoot this particular scene for which we used a fish tank. And we had to shoot this one particular scene, which Faisal will mention about, but it's one of the most important scenes of that film, which actually gives it a flavor. And also, Amber, in the name of the movie, is based on a little girl.
Right.
Her name is Anika, and she's another very talented actor. And
we have seen it. She
yes.
she was here for one of the episodes,
yeah.
For one of the films. Yeah.
So why don't you talk about that?
Yeah, for sure. So there's a scene in the film where one of the characters is trying to be drowned inside the sink. So obviously when we were shooting in the barbershop, we couldn't shoot it in the sink because it's where do you put the camera. So we had to simulate that entire scene in a fish tank, put a camera in a studio, put a camera below it, and essentially drown Joakim for real. Like, we didn't even try to do like any kind of trickery. We had him hold him down for like 10-15 seconds each, just to really get that expression of a guy just like
yeah.
really struggling for breath.
Right.
So props to him for being such a gentleman about it, such a champ about the fact that let's go for it. Like, whatever gets a great performance, let's go for it. And Anika, she's wonderful. She only had to give really some audio and a picture that we have of her, but she has such an innocence to her face
yeah.
that when you see that picture in the film, you know that why this guy is struggling, because it's such an innocent person
right.
that you have to sort of do something to save her.
Right,
yeah.
right.
And the most important thing for the film, in this film specifically, is sound.
Right.
The score and sound played a very, very important role for the film.
Absolutely.
Am I right?
Yeah, for sure. And I mean, Kane Rodriguez did the sound on location, so getting all of those little elements of people picking up sounds, the shaving happening and all of that stuff was great. And as I mentioned, Isaac just being a
yeah.
gentleman, getting his best score, yeah.
What's the future?
For sure. I mean, I'm working on a couple of feature films. In fact, Amber, when I originally wrote it, it was not really envisioned as a feature film. It was its own contained story. But
right. Everybody
who watches the film really wants to know more about that world. Like, where would the story lead to? Where is the larger kind of context of this world? So during the pandemic, I was just sitting at home and I was like, okay, if I had to really force myself in figuring out what's a great extension of the story, what would it be? And it hit me. At some point, I realized, okay, I have a good take on this. So I've written a script over the pandemic of
right. A
feature film that's a longer version of that.
Wow.
And yeah, hopefully I get to make that because I would love to explore more about these characters, more backstories, and sort of where things lead from what the events of this film is.
So there's definitely a possibility to Amber to come as a feature film.
Yep.
Am I right?
Yeah, fingers crossed.
So guys, here is all about Amber. I'm excited, are you? Last message for our viewers.
For sure, so I would like to thank Emirates Short Film Festival for giving us a platform and screening a film. It's always exciting to see a film with an audience. We had a couple of really good screenings of the film, but because of the pandemic, a lot of the film festivals we submitted to were virtual. So it's great to just come back again, watch it with film audiences and watch so many great movies that other people have done in cinemas. And I hope you guys can join us. I would love to see you there.
One important message that I want to give is that this region is giving a lot of support to a lot of upcoming and budding filmmakers, especially for the short film segment and documentary. And I think such film festivals like the Emirates Short Film Festival, showcasing all those films gives hope and gives a promise to upcoming filmmakers, especially people who are studying or people who want to make films, or even people who want to join with other filmmakers to make a product. It's a good showcase for the Emirates Short Film Festival, and I just want to say thank you for that.
This is all about Amber. It will be showcased between 13th of December to 15th of December at Vox Cinema Dubai. Grand finale will be on 17th of December, the Friday.
Yes, thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, so fun experience. Yeah. In just a few minutes again, we're going to come back. So we're pretending.